Since their inception in 1972, the New York Islanders were Long Island's pride. A strong community bond and a team riddled with legends helped pave the way for one of the greatest dynasties in sports history. From 1980 to 1983, the New York Islanders won four straight Stanley Cups, and in the process set professional records for most playoff series wins with 19, most consecutive NHL regular season wins with 15, as well as former Islander Mike Bossy becoming only the second player at the time to record 50 goals in 50 games. After winning their fourth straight cup, only 11 years into their existence, it seemed that nothing could stop the Islanders' dynastic run. Fast forward to 1996. The glory days are long gone and the Islanders' dynasty is just history. The Nassau Coliseum is falling apart with multiple reports of asbestos, a ceiling that literally rained on the crowd some nights, and a team that had finished 25th overall out of 26 teams following the 1994-1995 NHL season. The owners were all but removed from the team's affairs, and not a single executive seemed to care for the pride of Long Island. All of a sudden, from seemingly nowhere, a Texas big shot by the name of John Spano announced that he had a deal in place to purchase the Islanders with the intent of renovating the Nassau Coliseum. Islander legend Clark Gillies acknowledged him in his number retirement speech, and fans were convinced that he was Long Island's messiah.
There's been a commitment made here in Long Island by a fellow by the name of John Spano.
Until a fan's worst nightmare became reality. On July 23rd, 1997, federal prosecutors on Long Island charged John Spano with multiple counts of bank fraud, wire fraud, and forgery. Here's the story on what would become one of the greatest scams in professional sports history. Here's the story of the big shot, John Spano.